Domdus is the handsome Asian gentleman. Threat, do you agree?
Yes. I think he looks like the Asian Tom Cruise.
The Asian Tom Cruise. Do you think that's a good comparison there, 00?
Yes, absolutely. Him or Brad Pitt, either way, he's a very good-looking man.
Yeah, and we saw a little bit about Kitkatz, too. He has lived in the Archon team house for quite some time now, and he says all they do is play Hearthstone. So, The Rat, do you think team houses in Hearthstone are a good thing for the game?
I think it's a good idea if you want to practice. I'm not convinced that Archon's practicing that much, though.
Whoa. Shots fired. Do you think Illuminati's going to have a team house?
We'll see.
Is Koyuki going to be able to wield a sword in the Illuminati team house?
If we have a sword, he can go for it.
Are you afraid of the prospect of Koyuki wielding a sword in the potential Illuminati team house?
Yeah, that's probably more detrimental to my health than I give it credit for.
00, are you afraid of the potential of Koyuki with a sword in the Illuminati team house?
I'm afraid for the other members of Illuminati if that would to happen.
All right, well, good luck to Illuminati if they have a team house and a sword. But I think the matchup is just about ready, so let's send it over to the guys on the desk.
Thank you, TJ. So we're about to get into this match here. We talked a lot about the looks of the players, but I don't know if that really makes much of a difference in actual play in Hearthstone. As good-looking gentlemen yourselves, do you think your good looks have led to the success of your prowess in the game?
All I know is there's a Korean guy named Handsome Guy.
Oh.
And if you Google Handsome Guy Hearthstone, you'll find no images of him. You'll find a lot of Brian Kibler. And if you scroll down far enough, you'll find one of me and Trump.
Wow.
Yeah.
Words, Trump?
Yeah, good looks get you by everything. I know that.
Oh, I see. All right, well, I think Kitkatz has a decent shot in this. I mean, he hasn't received any love from the guys. It seems they have been taken by the charms of Domus's good looks. But I'd have to say that while good looks might be intimidating to your opponent in most cases, Kitkatz just doesn't really care about the other guy that much. I think it's all going to come down to the cards.
Hey, I actually think Kitkatz is favored. Like, he's might be facing against a future doctor, but he's a doctor of Hearthstone.
Whoa.
And we talked a lot, and he's proclaimed himself the patron master, and we're going to see if some of the players here think patron is super, super good, and we'll see if that's true here.
I've had the opportunity to interact with Kitkatz and cast him in a few tournaments so far, and I have to say he is the most confident Hearthstone player that I have seen in terms of overall confidence, and I don't think the results have particularly shown that, but I have amused myself greatly in the tournaments that he's participated in. So I'm really happy Kitkatz is here and part of this event.
Yeah, Kitkatz talks a lot about his warrior, but he told me he's been practicing a lot of Hunter.
Can you practice a lot of Hunter? I thought you'd just smork.
You can smork more efficiently.
Oh.
Yeah. Simple math, more efficient.
Okay.
So we'll see if that's true. He's leading off with Hunter.
Well, it is. It is a slow-ish Hunter.
That's an explosive trap.
Wow. With web spinner.
That's not good.
Is that like a weird synergy?
I think he was hoping to catch somebody off with that, but now that everyone has seen it and it's against a warrior, that trap's getting like no value.
Okay. I think I like the Armorsmith over the Cruel Task.
Yeah.
I think the Cruel Task is more flexible than Armorsmith is.
Yep, I think so too.
Cruel Task does challenge like a Knife Juggler, potentially a Mad Scientist.
And Glaivezooka. Yeah. But when you see the Web Spinner, you don't really expect Glaivezooka.
Ooh. Stampeding Kodo is actually pretty good drop
for
Kitkatz.
That's extreme arena value, by the way.
Yeah.
Yep, the unfortunate thing is getting the second trap there. Probably running the good old 2 freezing, 1 explosive setup.
Actually, because he played Cruel Task, Explosive Trap isn't so bad here.
I mean, his alternative is
Knife Juggler,
yeah.
They do the same thing.
Yeah, the problem with Explosive Trap is opponent might not just attack into it. It'll hold
the
off.
The reason I actually really like Explosive Trap is, one, it confuses your opponent. But the other one is you're going to have a trap right after that. and he might assume the next trap is also explosive, because I think these days it's pretty unusual to have explosive and freeze in the same hunter deck, isn't it?
Well, actually, in mid-range decks, you often see exactly two freezing and one explosive. I think that's the most popular setup right now.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think a lot of players are kind of moving away from that towards like either double freezing or like double freezing and one trap that's not explosive. I like Snake a lot, but once people figure out it's Snake, it's not nearly as good. I know that all the Archon guys had been running the double freezing, one explosive for a long time. They took that to Via game. So, pretty recent list.
Yeah, that extra trap really helps in making sure your mad scientists aren't dead. An unfortunate miss didn't get the acolyte there, but doesn't look like the acolyte can do.
Yeah, the acolyte can't really do much. It's just going to gain him an armor, maybe.
No. Yeah.
I think with a hand as bad as it is, you actually do attack and gain that armor.
Sam's not bad.
You should probably force your opponent to make the attack.
Yeah, get that armor smith out. He's debating between it and armoring up. Maybe try to get more armor out of the armor smith later, but I think developing it now is great.
Yeah, I would also just play the armor smith.
It just feels like in this matchup, the hunter absolutely needs some damage at this stage in the game.
Yeah.
And the more crap you put on the board, the less of a chance you're taking damage.
Right. And one of the ways the hunter can win is come around turn 6. They just drop a Savannah High main into a boom, maybe into another Savannah High main. And Warrior struggles to deal with all of them. Mm-hmm. Like, Shield Block Shield Slam will deal with one, but it leaves behind 2/2s. Execute might deal with another. But then there's another, maybe. So you can either get early pressure or you can get a real big mid-game swing with the Savannah High mains.
Yep, right here, Domdus has his choice of pretty much Shield Block, Shield Slam.
Yeah.
See if he gets another option.
Nope. I think he will Shield Block, Shield Slam the 4-3. He could just armor up Shield Slam, but at this point, your hand's pretty heavy. You just want to cycle, get more armor.
Yeah. This isn't looking bad for Kitkatz, even though the warrior has quite a bit of health. Unlike the face hunter, you're just setting up for that turn 6. Right. You want to have the board.
He really needs to draw high main though. But this Kodo is pretty good.
Unleash is pretty useless.
Yeah, one of the worst cards in this matchup. That's the reason a lot of people have cut down to one, is against like Patron and Control Warrior. It's not as good, even though it's great in the mirror match.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kind of a funny card against Patron, because Patron is like no creatures or too many creatures.
Yeah, if it's good, you're probably already dead.
Yeah.
And does not get a high main.
But a kill command here is fine. You still maintain decent board control.
You could freezing trap it.
Is that really worth it?
You're never going to get great freezing trap value against warriors. So, giving them an 8-mana Shield Maiden, not a huge deal that they can gain more armor later.
It is more mana efficient.
Yeah, and it saves you 5 damage anyway.
That's strange coming from you. It's like, oh my gosh, you're giving him 5 armor.
Well, like you said, it's more of the mid-range hunter. Like, you're not in a rush to kill him. You do eventually need to worry about damage.
I think the more I look at it, the more I like Chalky's play of Freeze Trap.
Yeah, you can squeeze in a hero power. Fit the Haunted Creeper in. Just get it all in there.
Yeah, it's certainly not bad on the first Shield Maiden. Like, if it's super late game, though, then the Freezing
super
Trap
late
is...
game, Freezing Trap is, like, healing them.
Yeah, how much this one's a close one.
How much information do you get when you see this line of play?
See, like...
Like, do you realize that he has, like, a very similar turn?
This is interesting. Like, because what is Freezing Trap really doing here? Now you give your opponent the option of what they want to set into it.
Right. I like Haunted Creeper better. It gets stuff out on the board.
Yeah. If I would have Freezing Trapped, I would have also power Haunted Creeper over Kill Command, but maybe Kitkatz knows what he's doing. He did say he practiced a lot of Hunter. Mm. And he definitely knows Warrior, so he should know what his opponent's like trying to do.
Armor.
Yep.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know how much he's seen into it, but he's going to play Dr. Boom next turn, so probably his thought process is his two minions is able to clear the board against whatever he's going to play, and then play the Boom.
Yeah. The Freezing Trap will hit a Shield Maiden in the end, so...
It's about
kind
the same.
Of cleared them both, like, in the same turn.
Yeah, when you look at the results here...
Preemptively cleared one.
Yeah, the Freezing Trap was better than the Creeper.
And, pretty sure we'll just see Boom here. And yep. That might lead to a Brawl.
Yeah, it has to be Brawl.
Question is, do you leave your Shield Maiden in the Brawl, or do you freezing it first?
Wow, he's thinking about playing around Brawl,
probably freezing
playing
it
the high
as well.
Main. Nice. Who does play the high main?
Yep, just goes for the high main. I think he's more scared of Big Game Hunter with this, though.
Okay.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
It's tough for Kitkatz. A lot tougher than if... Or tough for Domdus, a lot tougher if Kitkatz had played Boom.
Yeah, with the Alexstrasza and the Belcher, he can stabilize later, though. So as long as he can like keep the board pretty manageable, then it's okay.
I think I like... You can like Shield Main again.
I mean, that could very well just be his play, yeah.
Because he's not going to trade. He's not going to run a high main into a Shield Main.
No way.
So you just get a Brawl next turn.
Yeah.
Yeah, the only alternative appears to be Sludge Belcher, so I like that play.
Yeah.
What Domdus has to worry about is that actually...
Right. I think you just have to put it into the Savannah. Just check. Could be Snake Trap or something. You actually saw Explosive, and Explosive and Snake is a pretty common combination. Mm-hmm. If it was Snake, you'd get a really sick Brawl.
Yeah, and if it was Explosive, you could get a good Brawl also.
Yeah. So he decides to go with Belcher, though. It's pretty interesting. I feel like that's one of the better stabilization cards later over an 8-mana Shield Maiden.
It does prevent a lot more damage, though. Like, the Belcher stops 9 damage and you armor up. So you get 11 mitigation instead of 5. It's like gaining 6 life.
Yep.
So, I mean, there's some merit to it.
Yeah, right now it's blocking a lot.
Yeah, the trade-off is that was your one chance to... It was one chance to play the Shield Maiden.
Yeah, perfectly on curve.
Tame board.
Oh, it doesn't absorb as much here.
Yeah.
Oh, it does.
Still not going for the Doctor Boom. Kind of reads his opponent as having an easy way to answer it.
I wouldn't play that.
Yeah, that's good against Brawl. I like that.
Yeah. Probably going to see, like... We could either see a Deathbite or an Execute onto the Savannah High Main and then a Brawl. But...
I think Execute is the card.
Yeah. Deathbite spends more mana.
Yeah, you can't really do anything after you Execute besides armor. But that might be good enough at this point. I mean, you have Alex. You have another Shield Maiden.
Yeah, you feel confident enough with your opponent only having 2 cards.
So what lived? 2-2. Nice. That's good for him. He's still taking quite a bit, though, and he actually doesn't have an answer for Boom.
Patience of Kitkatz paying off.
Yeah, another Freezing Trap.
Now that one you definitely don't play.
Yeah, you just need to get the hero power damage in.
Impressed by Kitkatz. Pretty much Dr. Boom on 7 was like the very common play. Instead, he chose to spend 1 mana less and
get the high main out. Yeah.
Yeah, it worked out a lot better. Thing is, if Domdus didn't have the Brawl, or the Big Game Hunter, which he obviously didn't have either. Doctor Boom, I think, would have closed out the game there.
I think you actually strongly consider just core howling Boom. Even knowing you're, like, dead to... Would you be dead to Kill Command?
Yeah.
You've seen one already.
You'd be dead.
You've seen one already.
Yep.
You have seen a Kill Command already.
Well, Alistraza
you know that
coming
deck
down
play.
Right after.
Yeah, exactly.
I think it's fine.
You want to set up a winning play, not like a
right.
Hope I don't lose, play Shield Maiden, because then you're not clearing Boom ever.
Mm-hmm.
You have to clear Boom.
Yep, doesn't feel good, but I like it.
Yep, I really like this play. It's going to set him up to win the game.
Actually, watching your games, Trump, was a lot like this. It was like, you know, we'll do this play that doesn't play around most of anything, but
yeah,
I'll win if it works.
It's actually
and
kind
for
of
you, it worked quite a bit.
Kind of a low percentage play, but it's going to work out here.
Better than 0%.
Right. Yeah. Mad Scientist, vanilla 2-2 at this point.
Or is it?
Oh, it could be a fourth trap. Oh, man.
Misdirect.
So we're going to see the Alex to his own face against a board of 2, 4, 5, 6, 10 damage.
Second Brawl.
Ooh.
Attacked against Patron, probably.
That could be... No, that's not going to work.
Just going to kill off the beast. Hit his face.
Uh-oh.
Taking 6 on the 8 on the backswing.
Ooh.
Pretty good.
That's a decent draw.
Yeah. Fools. So you can load that breathing and hero power. The warriors had a lot of stuff to stabilize, and
wait,
it still might not be enough.
He just missed lethal. That was 8 bomb damage to the face, the 1 pound and hero power.
Oh, man.
There was a chance.
Yep.
1 in 16?
1 in 16.
Wait, no. Not bad.
1 in...
No, 1 in 16.
1 in 16.
He needed both fours to face.
No, but you have to consider it's half each time because of the Alex.
Yeah.
No, it's...
So it's 1 in 4 and 1 in 4.
No, it's 1 in 64.
Oh.
Yeah, 1 in...
Oh, crazy.
1 in 8 and 1
okay.
in 8.
Exactly. I like Kitkatz's play. No, seems fine to me.
Okay.
Okay, unstable ghoul. That gives him an even
nothing.
Better chance to stabilize.
Yeah.
Well...
No, I'm going with nothing. Like, there's no stabilize here.
Well, you're at 12 with the shield maiden and the unstable ghoul.
Yeah, but you can't clear off anything.
You can never clear off anything.
Yeah. You can kill the... Mad scientist. Oh no, that probably kills you.
It's not a guaranteed death if he goes unstable ghoul shieldman, at least according to the board here.
Yeah, but the bombs.
Yep,
bombs are rough. I wonder.
The other calls a Hail Mary brawl.
Yeah, but you're right. It has to be.
Yeah.
Has to be ghoul shieldman.
So brawl's a 1 in 7. And then you have to survive bombs. You have to not take 5. This.
Is
I think you definitely don't attack with your Alex, that is.
Right.
Oh.
No.
I think he really would have needed freezing the shield maiden next turn.
No, it was probably I guess I'm screwed, and let's really hope that's
really
explosive.
Really hope it's explosive.
Yeah.
And that'll do it with the owl.
Yeah, that's just lethal straight up.
So, Hunter wins.
It's good stuff. That was
yeah.
much more of a complex match than I had thought it would be at the start.
Yeah.
Might look like a crushing with the Hunter at 29, but...
It really wasn't.
Domdus was kind of close to stabilizing.
Yeah. He was on the verge of stabilizing on several different turns, but it was just, you know... Hunter was up like 1.5 creature throughout the whole game.
Level 51 Hunter from Kitkatz. So
whoa.
He's getting there.
He's getting there.
You know.
Yeah. All right. Well, first round to Kitkatz. That's got to favor him, even though Hunter probably didn't have too much trouble taking
too
up the game.
Too hard of a path. Yeah.
But, yeah, pretty good stuff. What did you guys think of the Control Warrior of Domdus? That was fairly unusual. Even compared to all the other control warriors we saw today, which you know, we expect people to kind of tech a little bit to the meta.
It was a bit more greedy of a list with like the Gore Howl, which I personally like, but obviously doesn't work too well being greedy against a hunter. 2 brawls didn't really save him that game. The first brawl was pretty nice.
I like brawls, just a fun card to just see. It's like, oh, he always has this option, which probably won't work.
Yeah, this is kind of a matchup of anti-patron warrior versus patron warrior. We've got Kitkatz bringing it. We've got Domdus obviously teching in the 2 brawl against patron warrior. And the mid-range hunter was always good against control warrior anyways. I expect Kitkatz to... I expect Domdus to try to bring this warrior again because he really wants to match up against patron warrior.
I think the more interesting story here is that Domdus seems very clearly teched against patron.
Mm-hmm.
Which means his other decks might be as well, which means Kitkatz's patron warrior, despite being known as like the strongest deck in the meta, might have a tough time getting a win in this match.
Yeah, Kitkatz was just bragging to me entirely off. Just like, oh man, which fools didn't bring patron warrior? It's obviously the strongest. And he was out there challenging everyone to
Well, we do see the warrior mirror here. It's not exactly going to be a mirror, because you guys are pretty sure it's going to be a patron warrior from Kitkatz, but... it seems like Control Warrior does have a pretty good matchup against Patron Warrior to begin with. It seems with tech cards even more, but like what do you guys give it? Like it can't be higher than 60. Just can't.
Well, double brawl is definitely gonna help. Mm-hmm. It makes it so the Patron Warrior almost certainly can't go for the aggressive way to win, which is just making a bunch of patrons and hoping they don't have Brawl,
yeah.
since their chances are doubled. Kitkatz didn't see both Brawls, so there's a chance he kind of fumbles and goes for that line and gets really punished. Mm. But even with the players that think patrons favored, I don't think they put it anywhere over, you know, 55 to 60%.
Yeah.
And well, I'd say it's much closer.
I want to put it this way, though. If you are bringing an anti-patron lineup, you are actually trying to get over 60% against patron. So I have to feel like Domdus has made this matchup thinking it's over 60%. To some extent, like, I'm actually rooting for that, too, since I didn't bring patron in my list.
Well, that's a good hand for Domdus. He's going to pitch a brawl because he's probably going to draw the other one anyway.
With Harrison and the Acolyte, yeah.
Right. Harrison is very key.
Kitkatz with a nice basic hand.
Yeah, Kitkatz's hand doesn't have too much action, though. Like, Armorsmith isn't that amazing. Loot Hoarder dies to Acolyte, which we're very likely going to see coin Acolyte into Acolyte. And he doesn't have a Fiery War Axe to kill those off.
One thing that I'm kind of wondering now, I know we talked about it at the start, and here it is, the Unstable Ghoul. You mentioned it's like teched against Patron Warrior, but I remember at the start of the matches today, we were talking about how that card may actually be a big liability against Patron Warrior.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Where does it sit in your mind?
That card's not good against Patron Warrior. That's like teched differently against like Hunters. Mm-hmm. So it seems like he's trying to go both ways, trying to get the two most popular decks with certain tech choices.
But so far, people have agreed that it's not possible.
Yeah, that seems to be the general consensus, is you're going to have to pick one out of the two. You can't really beat both decks with a lineup in Conquest.
I see, a guy can dream.
I'm actually surprised. So he went with the Unstable Ghoul because, like we just said, it's really bad in this matchup, so you might as well get it out while you can. But this is actually more of a respect play, where a lot of pros will always talk about, if you play something that an Acolyte kills in the Warrior Mirror, you always have an axe behind it to kill the Acolyte. So you should never throw out your Acolyte if you expect your opponent to be, you know, rational because they have the axe. But Kitkatz didn't have the axe. So the Acolyte would have been a really good punish for the Loot Hoarder, but decides to get the unstable value when he can.
Wow, Kitkatz's hand is really heating up here.
Yep.
I think Kitkatz might have given the Frothing Berserker play a small consideration in the last turn as well.
Yeah.
Sometimes when you're playing Patron Warrior against Warrior, you have to consider, is it worth it to go for the risk to just try to finish the game off early?
It feels like with Domdus drawing so many cards, because he's playing kind of like the anti-combo, it kind of feels like Domdus is going to be ahead here.
Here we go. Boom. Domdus has the best card against one charge Death Smite. We make Patron Warriors cry with this play.
Kitkatz visually upset.
Could have been worse, is what I say. Yeah, you could have been worse.
You can be as confident as you want in your Warrior play, but when you get Harrison, you're really unhappy. He has all three pieces for... all five pieces, if you want to call it that, for a really big frothing combo.
Really looking for that sweet, sweet Thor soon on six.
Yeah.
Seen a lot of that today.
So he's going to Battle Rage for two, which is pretty good, but obviously you could get better. Mm-hmm. But decided he's just going to settle. He has enough draw in his deck. And like Trump said, really dig for turn six Emperor.
What do you guys think for like advanced play? Like the one health Kitkatz is missing is from the Unstable Ghoul going face. Do you think maybe you'd even hold off that attack?
You can. But as the warrior, as the controller, you will have to kill them, or else the double frothing combo will kill you eventually. Mm-hmm. So you have to make attacks eventually. And I would say if you expect to get a decent amount of damage in, you should attack face. In this case, we know it would have been better to not attack face because the ghoul only got one in.
Yeah.
Like, one is not worth a card.
What? Yeah.
So.
What's the break point, you think? Like, three? It can't be two against the warrior. It has to be, like, three.
Yeah, probably around three. And I actually remember in WCA when Zillay and Firebat played against each other, they both didn't armor.
Okay.
They just, like, it was a mirror match, and they just decided, nah. Like, they wanted cards.
Mm-hmm.
So, when it comes to pro matches, you know, a lot of people will not armor, not attack, whatever they can do to play for Battle Rage.
That also is very common in extremely not pro matches, like when you make a new Hearthstone account. It kind of weird how it goes full swing.
Yeah, same with Hamlock. When you miss attacks,
oh, yeah.
It's not that you're forgetting.
Yep.
Ooh.
Wow, right back at you. Patron running Harrison Gens. Interesting.
Yeah.
We'll be waiting for the Death Spite or the Gore Howl. Yeah. He has seen the Gore Howl before.
That. I think he's just waiting for a better opportunity. Like, the three attack weapon doesn't threaten anything.
Also, your opponent, there's a small chance, will just play a two-charge weapon after they attack with this one.
Mm-hmm.
Or play a Death Spite now to kill your Armorsmith. And in that case, you get much better value.
Yeah.
I think Kitkatz is going to hold this Death Spite charge for a long time because it's really going to help his OTK combo, which is pretty much his win condition at this point.
Frothing charge, whirlwind. Hopefully with a Tharson for another like whirlwind and inner rage.
And hopefully then, not in that order.
Yeah. We would get the idea.
I don't know.
Get those frothings to like the mid double digits a piece.
That would be a bad screw up to make.
I'm just choosing not to play the mana-efficient Sylvanas right now since Perfect Clear is on the opponent's side. But yeah. That might have been useful to get rid of that charge.
Yeah. I mean, the Patron Warrior does not want to part with their second Deathbite second charge like,
exactly.
Just for your 5-5. But Sylvanas is a very important 5-5.
Wow. So much damage in his hand.
Yeah.
What
mana
really
is the constraint right now, yeah.
He might be forced to play Harrison just because he
it's
needs
the
to
only
draw
thing
a card.
You can play, yeah.
That is actually the only card he can play.
Kitkatz had dreams of getting that Gore Hell into the museum. He really wants it. Trying to think of a way to not play Harrison.
You could armor pass. I guess he's thinking right now whether he attacks first or not. And the attack is good, like, value-wise, but you lose a lot of damage on your combo.
You do. That Death Spite represents two times however many number of minions are out on the board.
Now, yeah. I know it's a bad idea, but I'm just kind of curious. I think a lot of people might have this curiosity as well. Maybe you guys can maybe explain it better. How dumb is it to, like, half combo here, clear up the board and do some face damage?
Really bad. Like, you won't win the game ever.
Okay.
So, generally, you need to hold on. Like, when your hand is like this, your win condition is the combo. And so, kind of going half in doesn't ever work.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You can see Kitkatz's agony on having to use that last charge of the Death Bite.
Yeah, that Death Bite
warrior so many times
was about, like, 16 damage. 4 to face, and then, like Trump said, 2 damage for each minion the whirlwind hits. Mm-hmm. You at least hit 3 of your own. You had a 4th one out, and your opponent had 2. That's 16 damage he just gave up.
Was that worth it?
Potentially. Depends on how the match kind of pans out. Obviously, we can kind of hindsight it then.
Mm-hmm.
But he felt he had to use it. He did rope on the decision, so we know it wasn't easy.
Yeah. 14 cards.
Yeah,
Kitkatz is sweating. He has no play here.
He really wants Emperor. It would make life so easy.
He does have a play here. His win condition is super frothing. I think you consider the
what now? Oh, we're 2 turns off super frothings.
Grommash.
You could just Grommash, but
if you're not doing 10 of that, you might actually just lose the game.
Yeah, the Death Bite kills off the Armorsmith, procs the Grom, and then Execute or BGH clears it.
Yeah, it's too weak.
You might just Axe Face, Hit Face, Armor Pass.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. This is that scary part about Grim Patron. Sometimes you just don't get all the pieces.
Yeah.
It's going to be
some awkward spots.
Grommash only going to deal 4 instead of 10 or 12.
Yeah. And Domdus does have the BGH, so not sticking around.
Unfortunately, no creative way to... Actually, no. There's no way to steal Grommash.
I wonder...
Domdus has a pretty good Grommash play. Hit face for... Oh, no, he can't if he wants to BGH. So, with 5, I guess he plays a Sludge.
Hit face for a bunch and then die? Yeah, that could work. Yeah, Sludge is pretty good.
If he had 2
here.
More mana, he could have actually stolen Grommash.
Like, this is the point where the Death Bite would have won Kitkatz the game. Like, if his first one didn't get Harrisoned, he would play a Death Bite, kind of clear the Belcher, and next turn just win. You
really
could consider Warsong here, too, since you have 2 of them.
No, I think you save a Warsong for Grim Patron.
No, for some reason I thought the slime was coming out, but...
Oof, Domdus with all the answers, a nice amount of health. Looking good.
Yeah.
Still always not safe.
Nope, that frothing combination does a lot of damage.
Yeah.
The only good thing for Domdus is that Kitkatz hasn't drawn too much. He only Battle Rage for 2. So, I mean, the worst the combo can be isn't that bad.
Yeah, sometimes it's difficult having a Sludge Belcher out as well because you're a little afraid of the Grim Patron, but here it's really helping out. Even the Ooze will be great.
So this is a point where Domdus is going for like a much more aggressive play than just playing completely defensive.
That's a nice Emperor.
Yeah, just plays a 5-5.
Oh, wow.
Okay. If Kitkatz survives, which he won't, but if he did, he might win.
Yeah, he won't.
It's the quicksand. You check, this isn't lethal, is it?
No, it can't be because you can't use both whirlwinds.
Yeah.
He had that Emperor earlier.
Yeah, you have to Emperor first. Right. And that's just not happening. Yeah, like, if he Emperors, he has the Whirlwind as well, which is not going to, so he's dead.
Yep. Unfortunate for him. Came, like, just barely too late. Things just didn't happen very efficiently for him. And Domdus is going to take it with Grommash
on the board.
Slam.
Grommash Shield Slam his own Grommash.
Let none Whoop. Survive.
Gotcha. Or, okay, no, he can't top deck him because he's one off with the Gore Howl. Man, could have made him really salty.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, evens it up here. Pretty good stuff. I mean, was that the first Control Warrior versus Grim Patron Warrior that we've seen?
I think we might have seen one more in Koyuki's match. Not sure.
Oh, I didn't see that.
Yeah, because there was a Koyuki match where he lost 2 games with the patron.
Well, that's still pretty interesting. You know, one deck tries to combo out. The other one tries to draw enough cards to get the cards that deliberately deny the combo. It kind of feels like both decks try to draw out specific cards that combo with each other.
Yeah.
But, I don't know. It's weird. I liked it, though. I thought it was pretty fun overall.
Yeah, it was close. One turn off, the other player winning.
Yeah, like people watching, I'm sure a lot of people have the opinion of, you know, this one guy has like 32 life and like 9 cards.
Yeah.
Against a guy with like 6 and no life at all. It's like, oh, what are you talking about? But, you know, every now and then those frothings like to hit for like the full health of a player apiece.
Yeah.
It's got to feel good for Domdus, though. He clearly brought to the deck with a plan to counter Grim
that
Patron.
That was a very important win, if his plan is indeed to counter Grim Patron.
Well, we will see how his plan is going to play out, and also where it was coming in as some of the other decks start to get revealed. So far, I do have to agree that the plan of Demigod has impressed me the most, with just you know, isolating Hunter and just punishing Hunter completely.
Yeah, he also said his lineup counters Handlock, which didn't apply in his group very much, but maybe coming out of his group. We know Trump had Handlock.
Yeah.
Both of these players could have Handlock. Might see a lot more hand lock as the tournament goes on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Kitkat switches it up. It's going to be interesting seeing which ones... there's been conflicting opinions on which deck is the better one right now on the players. Zoo, Handlock?
Yeah, I would expect Domdus to be Handlock, and I think Kitkat's potentially Zoo.
Mm. Well, let's see. This match is going to be a big one. Kitkatz with the Patron Warrior to follow, I think is still in really good shape. I think even though the score is 1-1, I kind of like to favor Kitkatz here.
I kind of like Domdus. Yeah. If his strategy is what we predicted, and he is indeed bringing good decks against Patron.
Okay.
If it is a good deck against Patron, then you'd think that Domdus would play Henlock then instead of
Zoo.
Yeah.
That's
kind of the mentality that I came up with.
Well, it's going to be a Handlock Mirror.
Wow.
And a BGH in hand for, I think that's Domdus.
Yeah, I believe so.
And I've heard from a lot of pros that going first in the Handlock Mirror is extremely important.
It's real good.
Yeah.
I've played Handlock a few hundred times that last season, so... I like cheating also in Handlock versus Handlock. Whoever brought 2 BGH in this matchup is going to be strongly favored.
Yeah,
that worked out for you pretty well so far.
Yeah, it's been pretty good.
Yeah, I like that approach as well.
It's very interesting.
Throws a Molten, gets a Molten.
Yeah, that 1 in 27, not bad.
The great thing about this matchup is... Ooh. Oh man, that is anti-patron.
So, right.
You can see Domdus is really following that strategy.
Mm-hmm.
Just like we expected.
Yep. Great thing about going first as a Handlock is you can actually just tap and then have your 4. Domdus really looking for it. Kitkatz is going to have to spend turn 3 possibly doing nothing.
From what I'm seeing, Trump, you're probably rooting for Domdus to take the group by storm so you can play him in the semifinals without your Grim Patron Warrior.
Oh, that's a good point.
Yeah, actually, both of the Group A qualifiers did not have Patron Warrior, so...
Yeah, but I feel Trump's decks punish the slower decks more, and that's what Domdus is playing. Like, I feel Trump's lineup against Domdus is kind of crushing.
Hmm. This is almost unfortunate for Domdus, but he did have a... Actually, he had the counter to either one. Sometimes it's Handlock versus Handlock. You don't actually need your 4-drop. You just have to have the counter 4-drop. Domdus has both.
Yeah. The Mountain Giant draw was really good, too. You can go tap Giant on 5.
Now nothing.
Yeah, Kitkatz can't be happy with this.
Yep, at least he has a play. Sometimes in a real disaster, wow, you have no play.
You like the Mortal Coil over the Ancient Watcher?
A lot of it has to do with being mana efficient in this matchup. I think you can afford to take the 2 and then just Mortal Coil the next turn.
Mm-hmm.
Requires a lot of discipline sometimes. This isn't bad.
Job's done.
Just has that good old freebie tap.
Tap Giant into Emperor next turn on 9 cards. Pretty ridiculous.
Nah. 9 mana, end of turn effect? I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah. That's a card now.
Yep. The only thing that Kitkatz has to be sad about is that he can't tap here since he is at 9 cards. He has to play the Watcher. Sometimes you just gotta do that to...
I don't think it's that bad, though. Like, Domdus is gonna play the Emperor here, and it's pretty nice, Argus.
Yeah. I think I like getting minus 9 mana on my hand.
Hmm. And you always salivate over the possibility that you get minus 18 mana. Not gonna happen
man.
Here.
Yeah, not gonna happen here.
Unfortunately for Kitkatz, he doesn't have a Mortal Quill, but yeah.
Yeah.
Fender.
Hmm. With that Giant, though, would you consider maybe the Dark Bomb? Because you already got big game, didn't you?
No.
Oh, no, you didn't. No, it's
he big gamed. Yeah.
That's right, that's right.
So, I'd probably... Defender just to get the tap in.
Yeah, the good news is having played the Watcher, he can tap now. If he's feeling especially lucky that the opponent doesn't have a BGH or a Saffensil, he can do the Giant Dark Bomb play.
So many possibilities.
Yeah. Go for it.
That might just cost the game, I think.
Well, there's plenty of game left.
Yeah, but you lose so much temper here.
This is pretty bad, I think. Like, it's... You lose a Dark Bomb, you don't get Argus out of your hand, which is sometimes pretty hard to use. And, this does give your opponent the VGH tempo, kind of.
Yeah, Domdus has the...
He's got a pretty dreamy turn here, yeah.
Not only that, he also gets to tap with the VGH.
Of course, tapping first, in case he doesn't want to VGH that giant.
Wow, that's so brutal, that turn.
Yeah.
Okay. How about that?
Yeah, but how does he kill it?
Shadow Flame.
Oh, yeah, okay. You know, L, Shadow Flame.
Yeah, the big tough thing about the Shadow Flame is...
You need it later sometimes.
Yeah.
Some handlocks run one, some handlocks run two. If you run only one, you feel especially bad Shadow Flaming here.
Yeah. I mean, he probably has to. You almost certainly want an Owl, so you could maybe Owl Belcher.
What if you Owl Belcher and kill the big game just with the attack?
What if you don't Owl?
Then your opponent's probably going to get value off that Twilight Drake's health. Which is pretty unfortunate.
Yeah. I do at least like not playing Shadow Flame, though. You can't afford to take this damage, and sometimes your opponent might not even attack you.
Yeah.
So many. I think you just sound like Drake.
Well, yeah, you're pretty committed to that at this point. That's the only thing you really can do. If you play one of your 5-drops, you're very likely to get either Argus or Mortal Coiled, and your opponent gets to make use of the Drake health,
right,
which basically doesn't exist since you want to Owl it.
Alright, Domdus has a puzzle here. Usually you want to use your minions in Handlock versus Handlock to fight the minions, but the minion fighting is not very good for Domdus right now.
I wonder.
Not much of an alternative, though.
It might seem tempting to do 8 to the face, but that's sometimes how you lose this matchup.
Yep. He doesn't really have a great answer if he were to get, like, double Moltened in the near future. So...
I think a trade 4 to face and just boom it is good enough.
Yeah, Domdus does know, though, that Kitkatz doesn't have Mortal Coil, because otherwise he'd have used it.
Right.
And there's also a question of whether or not Domdus even wants to do 4 to face. Like, you can do the 4-1 into the 2-1. Maybe you just hold the 4-2 back and not do anything with it.
He kind of is winning the long game, but I think he wants to sort of try to set up potential lethal.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that a lot more.
Yep. Me too.
Oh, there it is. How about that?
Second big game.
Alright, looks like Kitkatz is the one trying to win the Handlock matchup. Domdus might also have to BGH.
Yeah, double BGH definitely isn't just good game on its own.
It helps a lot, though.
Helps a lot.
Here, Domdus has a good amount of stuff out. The Shadow Flame is looking tempting. There's no way to finish the 7-7.
Yeah, I don't consider that stuff very good, though. Like, the Ancient Watcher's not really anything yet, and the two of the stuffs are bombs.
The big thing to be scared of if you're Kitkatz is Domdus is representing 17 damage on the board with a silence, and then 3 damage is pretty easy.
I think I like the Belcher big game, which he is doing.
Yep.
It just doesn't look that threatening to me.
Over to Domdus land, something that will eventually be really good for Domdus is that Sylvana Shadow Flame.
Yeah.
Other than that, nothing too exciting this turn, so tap, see if anything.
That's reasonably good.
Yeah, you could use it to trade off for the Belcher pretty easily. A lot of it's going to come down to if the Boombots manage to kill off the Big Game Hunter.
Oh, I think you just take the Argus, the Boombot, kill the remainder of the Sludge in just one face.
Gotcha.
I don't think any Boombots are dying this turn.
think the nightmare here is actually you hit his face for a lot.
Yeah, I want to keep off that face, which is why Domdus may not have wanted to attack Kitkatz for 4 earlier.
Kind of like Argus here.
Yeah.
To kill the slime, and then you know he hasn't had Mortal Coil.
Yeah.
So the 4-2 gets challenged by the 2-1. Okay. Don't really know what purpose that serves. I guess he just wants to free up to tap next turn.
Yeah, it's kind of more Shadow Flame fodder.
Yeah, I suspect that Domdus has managed to get quite a few more taps than Kitkatz so far. A way to build the advantage.
Yeah.
Kitkatz is going to really look forward to playing Emperor, but I wonder if this play will be better now, Mountain Giant. With the Emperor Thorstand, Kitkatz can set up a good old Lord Jiraxxus Inferno turn.
Yeah, if you can get that off in the mirror, you're in pretty good shape.
Yeah, it's been said in the mirror, whoever gets Lord Jiraxxus down first is usually in a good spot, but even better if you get Lord Jiraxxus down and immediately get an Inferno.
Yep.
I think I like Emperor Tharson the most here.
Gotcha.
You have kind of a clunky
Ooh,
slot.
That trade.
Yeah, that trade sucks, but...
Well, if he hit you for 4, Molten Giant's suddenly pretty good.
Lets you get a clean Emperor off, and... Domdus doesn't have a great response.
Yeah, looks like Domdus's responses are limited to Owl, and then trading in 2 guys at the moment.
Only... an 8-card Emperor for Kitkatz. Sad days.
Sad days.
Does Domdus pull the trigger with Lord Jiraxxus? One of the benefits is that he can actually kill Thorasan with that.
Go to 10?
I think it's that or Shadowflame, actually.
Yeah, Jiraxxus could be a really interesting play here.
One of the big things I realized with playing Handlock a lot is that you can't be too afraid about just developing that Jiraxxus, even if you have the Molten Giant in your hand.
Yeah. Also, that Ooze... just realized. Might take some claws this game.
Declaw. Well, I guess there's another solution. You can hold off on the Jiraxxus, you do the Owl.
Yeah, the only bad thing about Jiraxxus is that Molten pretty dead.
Saw a quick roll over of the both decks. About 11 cards on both sets. Oh, he's going for it.
Yep.
I like it.
I like it too.
I think it's spirited. I think.
I think it's pretty gutsy.
Might have been good to wait a turn, do Owl Belcher tap. It's close.
I don't know. Now Kitkatz is basically on a clock. Like, do you just Jiraxxus right back in Inferno?
This is a pretty clear turn, but you have you actually can play Molten Giant, and I found that if you can play Molten Giant,
yeah.
It's usually better than Jiraxxus since Jiraxxus is there to make a. Inferno, anyways.
Yeah.
So
that's Sylvanas Shadow Flame. It's pretty good.
Pretty good.
Pretty good. Pretty good combo on 8 mana.
Especially since you can fit in a 6/6 from your hero power.
I see.
And Kitkatz is going to try to start rushing.
He's taking the opportunities away from his opponent. Could have played an 8/8 instead of 5/5, but valuing the Battlecry of Lothem.
Yeah, I agree with that. Just really needs to rush. He took away the Sylvanas Shadow Flame, which would have been devastating.
Right. Inferno Shadow Flame is still in play.
Yeah.
That's a 9/9.
That is a 9/9.
Well, that's one health your opponent can't take away right now. I think that's
go
correct.
Down to 1.
Ouch.
I think you do go to 1.
Go to 1?
Yeah, you can Molten Giant and Jiraxxus form.
Well,
that's like a tournament first.
We know Kitkatz, he already played 1 Dark Bomb, no Hellfire.
There's no way if you're Domdus that you can be willing to go to 1 against someone who's not played a Hellfire yet.
Yeah.
Not to mention,
I really want to see him do it, though.
Not to mention a silence would mess him up.
Yeah, I feel like if you're just in this spot, you're too afraid.
I think you play Sylvanas and you aim. Kill something later. Ooh. Yeah, no, you play Belcher, that's right.
Yeah, next turn he can Sylvanas Shadowflame. That's pretty good. Like, as long as he lives this turn, which he should with the Belcher.
Right.
Kitkatz instantly reaches for the Molten.
Because that is
lethal.
Easy kill.
Yep. Domdus kind of thinking it over. Yeah. Thinking if there was anything he could have done, and now he has to beat Patron twice in a row. Which,
well, he has set up for it, but still, we're talking about that with these really, really strong decks, especially the combo ones. You can set up against it, but you know you're still winning 60% of the time.
Yeah.
Doing that twice isn't that favorable.
Yep.
Domdus is probably still thinking about that last game. You can see his bows there. The big difference on that last one is whether or not he should have played Draxxus, and he's probably thinking it over right now.
I kind of liked it, though. I mean, did any of us really disagree with it?
It was definitely a viable play.
Yeah. So you can't really fault him too much for it. In the moment, four people thought it was decent, and he made the play.
At the end there, I guess his play was dead to Molten Giant Shadowflame, which it's sort of likely your opponent has. That is two cards instead of like one card, like a Hellfire or a Dark Bomb.
Mm-hmm.
So going to one, like Trump said, not what you want to do, especially in a tournament setting. I think a lot of players, and from what I saw in the qualifiers, even Domdus especially, are much less willing to take risky lines.
Yeah.
When there's so much to lose, right? Like you only get two chances in the groups.
So much to gain.
Yep. Good on Kitkatz setting that up, though, with the low thumb.
Yep. Really well played by him. He realized his opponent Draxxus. He wasn't going to win the value game. It's time to go.
Let's see if Domdus can snap off the Patron Warrior with this Handlock, a traditionally favored matchup for Handlock.
Yeah.
Though Kitkatz has boldly claimed that this matchup isn't so bad for him when he's Patron.
Yeah, I mean, I feel people claim both ways because they're a little swayed by like their latter experiences.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe crushing some not as strong players. At this event, though, everybody knows what they're doing. You know, everybody's played these matchups. They've won tournaments. They've won qualifiers. So I expect matchups to be a lot closer than what players, you know, think in their interviews.
I do kind of think that Handlock does particularly well against Grim Patron Warrior myself.
Yeah, I mean, in theory, it's so good against it, but in practice,
you can die.
Yeah. Well, the Druid has to follow that as well, and that might be a bigger problem.
The Execute, pretty good. And usually the Warrior's win condition in this matchup is going to be a Frothing Berserker combo.
Yep, feels pretty good to be Domdus. He's got two four drops. Unfortunate that he has to go second, but hey, he'll take it.
I think it's fortunate that he is going second because I think the extra cards and the coin make combo deck just in general much stronger.
Kitkatz kept his whole hand. He kept two Loot Hoarders and an Execute.
Mind if I roll me?
It's also kind of a mental thing. Like Lead Paint said, where when he saw Kalento keep three in the first game,
that was already an interesting turn. You can consider foiling there.
Yeah.
Because you do need one turn to not do anything if you're going to play Drake and then Giant.
Yeah. The lower you get, it gets scary. These extra twos just set you within the range of like a one frothing combo rather than a two frothing combo.
Ooh, draws into something you can play. That's pretty good.
That's very nice.
Pretty fortunate.
Kitkatz's
hand's pretty nice, though.
Domdus ends.
Yeah, wow. That's weird. Saving it for... Wow.
Oh. Aggressive.
Yeah. That's strange. Like, I wonder what Kitkatz's plan is.
Yeah, pretty straightforward plan. SM Orc.
Beat him up. Yeah, I think you can afford to save the Frothing, especially with the Emperor in hand. But gonna go for a really aggressive line. Just hope he has no way to deal with it.
Is good. I think just protecting the Frothing gives you a lot of damage.
I would probably... You could trade in the Loot Hoarder, or you could put your face into it. Your health in this matchup very rarely matters if you're ahead as the Warrior. Then it's basically the Handlock trying to outlast you.
Gonna spend
I think I agree with that, but at the same time, that Loot Hoarder is probably not surviving next turn. So I don't really like
actually,
that part.
Might.
What's that?
It very well might survive.
Yeah. Feels like Kitkatz is trying to force out some premature removal here. And then... But he doesn't really have anything to punish that. Emperor is good. But there is still just a giant out there.
So many possible.
Yeah, he could just silence the frothing here.
Or the card.
Like, how afraid of you are you of dying?
Pretty afraid. It's a frothing with a death bite. I think that's pretty scary.
Well, it's 9 plus 3 from the Rowan, so that's 12 on board, so you'd need to deal 7 damage to minions, which is really realistic. So yeah, I think you have to owl there. And now if you're Kitkatz, I mean, you removed one of your most likely win conditions. So, like, what's the plan now?
You can do the pretty basic play of drawing 2 cards of Battle Rage. Hard to deal with that giant.
No, I think I like the Emperor play.
I think he's going to full clear an Emperor.
Yep.
Because that's hard for Handlock to really deal with.
Makes sense.
A lot of people aren't running Siphon Soul. Yep.
Not now, as many cards as you would like to reduce, and not even any of them which really combo into anything.
Yeah, the Whirlwind reduction is okay. The Deathbite is okay.
I think those cards are pretty decent. I mean,
but the reductions aren't as relevant on them, I think.
Yeah, but at the same time, he hasn't really been able to draw much. Like, he had Loot Hoarders, which are mostly just cycle.
Yeah.
So he hasn't really pumped up his hand to, like, a high volume for him to get an extremely good Emperor.
He should be able to get a Battle Rage for 3 at least this game.
The bad news for Domdus is no way to deal with it, but at least he develops his own Emperor.
And we'll have to see how much Kitkatz goes face. You can Battle Rage for 4 now. I really like that. You also draw 1 off of the Acolyte. So he can draw 5 cards at least this turn.
3, 4.
It's going to cost him his Whirlwind, but...
It's a decent price.
Yeah.
Good value.
I would take that. You already have the Deathbite for another Whirlwind effect.
Right. You do want to not also play the Armorsmith, though, so you can Deathbite the opponent's Thorasan.
Yep. So gonna settle for 1 less card just to keep his Thorsen alive and kill his opponent's Thorsen. And with a Warsong Commander, Kitkatz would have a lot of damage.
Right.
He's gonna get a lot of mana reduction.
Kitkatz has to wonder whether or not it's okay to set his opponent down to 14.
Seems fine.
Feel like it is.
Yep.
But at the same time, he does just have a lot of damage anyway.
The scary thing about 14 is the worst case scenario is tap Molten Coin Sunfury.
Could,
3 of those.
He can Molten, like, Shadow Flame or just Shadow Flame Watcher. So he can finally clear out, but he's still just dead to Warsong anytime it comes into the hand. He's gonna have to find a time to get that Healbot and that Belcher out there.
Yeah, really scary to be Domdus because this is lethal rain for Gromish.
Yeah, just bad feeling all around. He will get an 8-8 out, though, and Kitkatz has been using his life as a resource like crazy.
Oh, that's definitely a consideration, doing the coin Sunfury. Doesn't feel good to only put it on one thing, but you have to defend against Gromish.
Yeah, he kind of sets up lethal this way, too. I mean, Kitkatz can obviously armor, but... He plays Argus, he plays Dark Bomb, plays maybe another Hellfire. Speak to me. And if Kitkatz can't really, like, dig for anything great...
I kind of like the Armor Smith here. You're pretty low. This armor is somewhat valuable.
Yeah. See what he gets. That's not going to help.
No, what's going to help is drawing a crazy amount of cards in the next few mana crystals here.
Yeah. He could gain a lot of armor. Question is if he's going to put his face in or just like he's doing right now, just re-equip. Besides, putting his face in is not worth it. And he gets to draw a lot here. He did have to use his Whirlwind, but he's going to have a 9-card hand. Draws another Whirlwind easily.
All right. We're in business for the patron.
Holy cow.
Wow.
I think, no execute, I think the though. Viewers just realized how broken this deck can be. Just right. Now. It just, like, turned on.
Battle Rage is one of the more broken cards in the deck. Mm-hmm. He's at 5 cards left. Almost cycled his entire deck. He's actually going to kill off his Acolyte for a 1 in 5 chance at execute.
Or that.
Oh, but he plays Big Game Hunter. That's a top deck.
Holy cow, dude.
I don't know if that's a top deck. Maybe
we just need
out
like,
of the 5
We need one of those like split screen before and afters.
Well, he already used one
right.
Execute.
So it was about a 50-50 then? 2 out of 5.
You have
two
to be depressed if you're Domdus right now.
So sad. Healbot Shadow Flame.
Yeah, or Hellfire Healbot.
Yeah. That has to be your play. And
I'd like Hellfire Healbot. Shadow Flame can be more useful later.
You're probably dead in your mind anyway, but I don't know if Kitkatz actually has it next turn.
With one Berserker out of the way, he doesn't actually have the other Berserker.
Yeah, the other Berserker's hiding in the bottom 4. Question is, how do you kill the warrior opponent before they draw literally their entire deck? And, of course, kill you.
The big scary thing about being the Handlock player is... the opponent hasn't used any Warsong commanders. Usually that's the limit.
Yep.
Or patrons.
Impressive on Kitkatz to be able to get Domdus down to 11,
yeah.
Having used 0 Warsongs.
So, I guess the bottom 4 are probably frothing, patron, patron, execute. That's probably it.
Let's go over then.
I think those are the exact 4 cards.
Unless he's cut an execute, but I really doubt that because of how aggressive he went for that draw last turn. And Kitkatz... immediately goes for it. Is this lethal, though?
Yes.
Are you sure?
No, I think it's just a set of death.
Yeah,
I think it's exactly...
I made 11, 14, 17. I see.
Yeah.
And it is pretty good to set the opponent down to 2.
To 2.
He's got 3 cards.
You have an axe.
Yeah, you're right.
You have an execute. You have another war song. Kickout seems like he's reconsidering now, but...
Too late.
This play is fine anyway. What? No. His opponent will live.
I think what he's considering is set the opponent down to 2 or to 5.
What?
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, this
denies him some stuff. Yep.
Like, he's going to draw into the other Grim Patron very soon, so that Whirlwind is never going to waste.
Well, if he just Shadow Flames...
He'll live.
He will live.
The funny thing is... The warrior has drawn his entire deck against the Handlock.
Oh, yeah.
The Handlock has no cards, and he doesn't even have 10 mana crystals to make a decent play here.
Patron Warrior draws a lot.
Yeah. Like, if you had 10 mana crystals, the play would have been adequate.
I mean, I think you have to tap here, too. Which then kills you, so no, you really can't.
Yeah, it might have to be Belcher Shadowflame.
Could be. I think I'd like Drake Shadowflame if I did that.
Oh.
Yeah, he's going to tap. I don't know. Maybe hoping he just doesn't play Grommish.
Well, that's it, I guess.
Even then, like...
you got to have hope.
Sending out some prayer somewhere.
Getting that first win.
And,
so important.
For Kitkatz's future opponents, they got to see 29 out of 30 of his patron deck list.
Damn.
And the 30th can only be... another patron. So.
Yeah. Well, good stuff. We will see Colento versus Kitkatz coming up.
Yeah. Kitkatz just chill.
I think both players had very dominating performances, but I think Kitkatz was a bit more complex in terms of execution. Colento's was mostly, oh, hey, these are the perfect cards.
Yeah.
I feel like Kitkatz is like patron warrior against Handlock. Another win, another day.
Right. Yeah. I thought it was really interesting... how Kitkatz kind of played the last game, more aggressively, just kind of knowing. He's like, yeah, I'm going to draw my whole deck anyway. Don't need both frothings.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it was some more interesting matches than that last match for sure, but yeah, it'll be nice to see them go head-to-head next match.
Mm-hmm. What about the Domdus versus Lead Paint to follow that? We might actually get to see Lead Paint make plays in Hearthstone. In a set of matches.
That'd be fun.
That'd be fun.
We could see a copy of Wild Growth in that match.
Mm-hmm. How depressing is it to, like, you know, just do a tournament, like, you know, maybe the first in a while,
right?
And just draw terribly and get 0-3.
Okay, so in January, right after GVG came out, I actually flew to Finland, and I played this kind of small tournament. A lot of people might know about it, called Assembly Winter.
Okay.
And I went 0-2 in that.
Okay.
And I got, this was in last year, a standing was still thing. I got 3-0'd by Paladin, and then I went up 2-0, and I got reverse swept by Druid. And each game was just like nothing I could do. Mm-hmm. So I flew out to Finland to go 0-2 and sit in a hotel for a few days. It's pretty bad.
Pretty bad. Well, the hotels here are nice, at least.
The hotel here is great, yeah.
Let's just check out the bracket for a second so people can see what the standings are like. We have the group up here, Group B. We've already completed Group A earlier today. And tomorrow will be the remaining two groups. But as it stands, Kalento and Kitkatz in the upper bracket, which we'll see play against each other in just a second, followed by Lead Paint and Domdus. The winner of the bottom bracket match will play the loser of the top bracket match for that second seed. Yeah. Well, we'll have to see how that goes, but for now we have, I believe, a few things to ask Kitkatz, and I'm sure he has a lot to say, Kitkatz being Kitkatz, and on the other end, that was a pretty interesting set of matches, so let's get to that, and maybe we can learn a few things.
Hello. Third time's a charm. All right, thank you very much, Crip. And it's now time for the interview with Kitkatz just to pull his thoughts about that series. So, Kitkatz, you started off the series pretty strong, and it's interesting that you were playing up against a Control Warrior class that you're known to be for, but you didn't even bring Control Warriors up. You bought Patron Warrior. Give me some thoughts as the resident Warrior expert here.
All right, I'm really sorry about not bringing Warrior, Control Warrior, everyone, but I had to take it out. I have a lot of experience in Control Warrior versus Midrange Hunter, and so I was able to kind of think about what he had in his hand, and that's why I chose High Main over the Dr. Boom, so I'd have a stronger recovery after Brawl, and I think that really shored up the victory.
Well, what were some of the other keys to victories overall, if you can look at the big picture, maybe not some of the individual turns, but did you feel like you had an overall advantage based off your lineup against Domdus?
I definitely felt like I had a huge lineup advantage against Domdus because he's playing Druid, and Druid's just not really a great deck at the moment. It's like 40-45% against the entire field, so it's like you're already like fighting a losing battle by bringing Druid.
Yeah, that's fair enough. That's why some people like it, though, because they feel like they have a good chance of drawing Wild Growth, but didn't really work out too much in this case. Talk to me about your new team, Kitkatz. You're on the Grand National Champion, so it feels good to get a first win under your belt under GNC, right?
Yeah, well, I'm part of Team KCtron's Grand National Champions, and it's just really good to get a win, my first win in my first match on the team. I'm just a hired mercenary, though.
For one tournament. And there only can be one cat, right? Because you're Kitkatz, and of course, Lead Paint used to be known as Cat Cam, so there only can be one. Well, congratulations, Kitkatz, but your job's not done yet. You have to go up against Kalento. Any thoughts about that match?
I think Kalento is like one of the best players in the world, so I have an uphill battle. I hope you'll cheer for me nonetheless, even though I'm the underdog. Thank you.
All right, well, an underdog story I can always get behind. So good luck in your next match, Kitkatz. In which case, we'll get ready after a quick commercial break. When we come back, more action here at the ESL Season 2 Legendary Series Finals.